that's why I'm here in AGT. This is my chance to show that I'm supposed to be doing this.
Hi.
Hello.
What is your name?
My name is Kevin.
Hi, Kevin, and where are you from?
France.
Where else?
Silly me. Welcome to America.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. And what do you do in France?
Mentalism.
Ooh. Mentalism?
Yes.
How old are you?
I'm 32 since yesterday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
So how long have you been doing mentalism?
12 years.
So you do it full time for a living?
Now, yes.
And what is the reason that you wanted to be here on America's Got Talent?
When you love something, you want to share with as much people as possible. And this is the biggest stage of the world.
Yes, yes.
That's wonderful. Go ahead. Mentalize.
I'm gonna show you a mind transmission performance, but between you, judges, and Mr. Terry Crews. Wow. Come on, Terry.
Okay,
come on.
I got you.
Mind transmission.
Thank you so much. Right, so I come to you. Okay, here we have got photos of AGT finalists from all the seasons of the show. Ladies, you will pick one each, and without showing it, look at it, then put it under your cup. Heidi, put your finger on a photo. Okay, take it, keep your finger. Perfect, thank you, that's yours, no worries. Sophia, put your finger on a photo.
This.
That one, take it. Okay, now let's do this.
Put it under your cup, he said.
Now, I'm gonna extract the mind of Terry. Then grab your thoughts and put it inside. And so, do a mind transmission. Keep your concentration and your eyes closed from now till the end. And imagine me extracting the mind from your head. And going inside.
Oh my God.
Then, deeper to your memories.
This is crazy.
Ladies, think about your contestants, their talents, their props. Heidi, I'm gonna extract the contestant from your mind. Does it make sense? Sophia, think about your contestant. Does it make sense? Then, Terry, imagine your mind coming back to your head. And open your eyes. Take these boards and write the names of the two contestants you felt. Terry.
Okay.
It's all up to you. Show us the board. Is that correct?
It is.
Oh my God!
Believe me.
I'm swimming.
It is. That's amazing.
That's great.
Wait. Wait. One last thing. Judges, at the very beginning, I left a photo of myself here. The other reason why I left it even before you chose your contestants is because this photo contains my prediction.
Whoa!
Thank you.
So good!
I mean, seriously, please.
Round of applause for Terry, come on!
Thank you. That was amazing.
Heidi, what'd you think?
I mean, we need one of those brain things that you had there. That was incredible. I've never seen anything like it before. And what you've done from my brain to Terry's, it was incredible.
Thank you.
Sophia.
I don't even know what to say. That was so much fun, and it was such a different thing to watch.
Thank you so much.
And Simon?
This act was sensational, absolutely sensational. It was taking this kind of act into the future. It was unlike anything we've ever seen before. This is a Vegas act, absolutely brilliant.
Thank you.
The magic is far beyond anything I have seen before. That was appearing in front of us. Those graphics were just floating in the air. I saw Terry Crews's brain in front of me.
It was crazy.
I think that's amazing. I've never seen anything like it. I'm so excited. I'm going to start off the voting with a, as you would understand, wee.
Oh, good job.
I give you your second wee.
We've had so many wees today, and now you've got a fourth wee.
Wee!
Thank you.
Is that the most
what
amazing?
Is that?
I thought I was watching something on my phone.
What is it?
It's magic.
Guess what? Four yes! I got it!
Howie?
Yes?
Just pick one of these cards, okay? Show it to the camera.
To the camera?
Yeah. I'll have the card. Can you open the marker?
Yes.
Write your name right over there.
Okay, perfect.
Sit back then.
Thank you.
That's your card. Open up the marker and write your name right over there. Very good. Show the camera.
wish I knew how you did that. Look, where did the cards go?
Where did the cards? Okay, well, a lot of people do ask that, Terry. Howie, can you try opening your cup? Just open it up.
Are you? No! No!
Is that your card, Terry? Look at that.
That's my card! And Howie's card! Unreal! Howie, listen, we were there. What do you think of that?
I had so much to say, but now I realize I'm holding cards that were in your mouth. Why would you do that?
Okay, hang on.
There we go. A little Santa Claus. Okay. Heidi, were you impressed?
Of course I was impressed. I mean, Shin, you did it yet again. You know, another jaw-dropping performance.
Thank you, Heidi.
Simon, the great Schindler.
I don't think many people, having won the show, would have had the guts to come back again this year and do what you've done. And for that, you have my utmost respect.
Thank you so much, Simon.
It is the best of the best. And still, within that context, you were amazing. Literally amazing.
Well, good luck tonight, Shin! One more time for the great Shin Lim.
Hello. Take a deep breath, take it all in, and tell me your name.
My name is Eric Chen.
And what do you do?
I am a magician.
Okay. You do that for a living?
I've only started performing for the past 6 months.
Oh, wow.
And here on AGT, magic is king.
Yes, I saw Shin Lim's act, but I think we're two very different people, and...
Who's better?
Oh, yeah.
You know what? Good luck.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
He's so nervous.
Yeah. Most magicians do that kind of suave, kind of like, ta-da, I got you. You look more confused than any of us. You're looking like, where did it go? Where did it? And I love that.
Thank you so much. That means a lot to me. Thank you.
Gabrielle?
I think I'm just as baffled as the audience. Like, how? Eric, you are magic. It is your time to step up and claim your place amongst the best. You are amazing.
Julianne.
The fact is, you don't have to compare yourself to anybody, and I'm really glad that you showed up as you.
Simon.
Couldn't have put it better. You know, Eric, genuinely,
I mean, this was in a different level. It was actually unbelievably good. And what I really love about you as well is that you're so humble, you don't even know how good you are. The future is in your hands from this moment on, because I think you're one of the best we've ever had.
Thank you so much.
All right, let's vote. I'm giving you your first yes, Gabrielle.
Two yeses.
Thank you.
Julian.
Three for me.
Simon.
It's four yeses.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, who are you?
I'm Moses. I come from Spain.
Well, welcome to America's Got Talent. What will you be doing for us today?
I'm gonna do some dance for you.
Okay, why America's Got Talent?
It's the biggest stage in the world. I'm so excited to be here. Thank you so much.
We've had nice people today. Yeah.
Because we are nice.
Are you super nervous?
A little, but excited nervous. I really care about this.
And who are you? What is your name?
My name is Anna de Guzman.
And what do you do, Anna?
I do magic.
Magic? How is it that there's not many women that are magicians that like to do magic?
I know, I'm one of the few, and I hope to inspire more girls tonight.
Okay, respect.
I'll be like her when I grow up.
How long you been doing this?
I've been doing it for around like 5 or 6 years, but I feel like my whole life, magical things happen all the time.
And how old are you?
I'm 24 now.
You're a baby.
Oh, thank you.
And Simon can't talk tonight, but I'm sure he's gonna wanna ask you if you have any pets.
I've never had a pet because I moved around a lot, but hopefully if I win, I would love to get a dog that I wanna put in the act.
Oh, fantastic. Okay, we're ready for you, and we're so excited that you came tonight to AGT.
Thank you for having me. Let's go. Okay. Judges, may I join you up at your desk?
Of course.
My biggest fear is falling down those stairs. Hi. I have a gift for this cutie right here. Sophia, could you hold on to that for me? Put it away. Anywhere
this?
Safe. Yeah, somewhere I can get to it. Yeah, right there. I will never touch it, I promise. Now, growing up as an only child with a single mother, I spent a lot of time alone learning how to entertain myself. When I found my first deck of cards, I was instantly captivated by the magic they seemed to possess. I became obsessed with this thing called cardistry. It's the manipulation of playing cards.
Whoa! What the heck?
Simon, can you shuffle these cards as good as I do? Don't worry, I didn't expect you to, but do your best. Now, I know you've seen a ton of great magic here on this stage before, so I wanted to create something special just for America where I don't even touch the cards. But before I do that, Simon, I'll take these back. Good. One more. Oh, fancy. Howie, I'm gonna riffle through the side of the cards. Just say stop whenever it feels right to you.
Stop.
Lock the card in your brain.
Okay.
Memorize it.
I got it.
Now, the reason I had you shuffle, Simon, is because a lot of people think my shuffling is suspicious, even though I think it's pretty fair. You could actually see each card, one by one. Number between 1 and 52. You could say the number out loud.
10.
10. Sophia, you've been holding on to these cards before we even started.
I have. They have a plastic on.
Go ahead and take the cards carefully out of the box. Sophia, Heidi was thinking of the number 10. Deal down 10 cards for us. 1, face up. 2, and we'll all count together. No, just like that. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Show everybody the two spades! That's two spades! Oh. Don't ever ask me! Yes! The two spades! I did not think it was gonna work! I thought I got stuck on you, but everything's landed! Didn't think it was gonna work at the end, so I fooled myself.
There's nothing more exciting when the magician amazes themselves.
Well, hopefully I amazed all of you as well.
Can I just say something? You are real. The fact that you were so nervous and not slick added to what we were doing. It was the most adorable, yes, fun, magical thing I have seen so far this season.
did you think?
I agree with Howie. You're totally a breath of fresh air. You showed us some magic that I have not seen before.
And apparently either is she.
And you have a $1 million smile on that face.
Thanks.
So Simon thinks you're annoying, likable, brilliant. Anna, we're gonna start voting. Simon.
Yes.
Howie.
Yes.
Heidi.
Yes.
Yes.
She saw the card, the two of spades, and more than the audience, she went, wow!
Yeah. You too, Howie.
You were on AGT 2015, and how did you do?
Third place.
You came in third place.
Over and over, I heard you should have won, so you know what? This is my moment to redeem.
Yes! Yes.
Woo! I like that!
Take us there, buddy.
People ask me all the time, what was it like being on AGT? And I tell them two things. First, I promised myself that if I ever had the chance to perform for you judges and all of America again, I would savor every single moment. And the second thing I tell people is that America's Got Talent turned my life completely upside down in the best possible way. Because moments are what define us. Howie, Heidi, Alicia, close your eyes. Go back in time to a day, a month, a year. Focus on it and the emotional significance it played for you. Now, everyone in the audience, grab your wallet, take a bill, any bill you want, and hold it over your head. Let's get Terry out here to help us out. Terry Crews, everybody! Terry, go to any person you want and grab any bill.
Okay. You got $1? $1? Okay.
Please. Hand that to Simon, fold yes. it in half. Simon, thank fold you. It thank again you, in half, please. I never want to touch it, I don't want to see it. You know what, I don't even want you touching it. Place it in an envelope yourself. Push it all the way in there, all the way.
I'm
push
trying.
It. And hold it right here up in full view. Are all three of my other judges focused on that moment in your life? Mm-hmm. Heidi, you can't contain your joy. This is a very happy moment. Person, people, more than one. Are you thinking of five different people?
I am.
And I see them, four are your kids, and then one more. It's a man, he's on his knee. This is your engagement, am I right?
Yes.
Heidi, do you have your phone?
I do.
Please go to the calculator. What I'd like you to do is you're gonna type in the day, the month, and then the year, please. Alicia, I saw you smile. I saw you relive this moment. Be honest, there's absolutely no way I could know what you're thinking of. Is that right?
Correct.
A word. What is the name in mind? What's associated with this memory?
Misty.
Are you being for real?
Yes, I'm for real.
Not even close. Dead on. Wow. But wait, what if we could combine two moments? Heidi, hit plus. Mm-hmm. And Alicia, what I'd like you to do is type in the day, the month, and then the four-digit year. Go ahead, please.
Okay, don't touch anything else.
Well, that's how we add them together. Okay. Heidi.
Yes?
Tell me, what are your two moments combined?
Five.
Eight.
Two. 0. 9. 0, 6, 1.
0, 6, and 1. Howie, you have a moment that you're focused on.
Okay.
Focus on the significance. Oh my, it's getting hot and heavy.
Woo!
What is the day?
The 16th.
The month?
March.
03. What year?
80.
Heidi.
Yes.
Let's combine your three moments. Hit the plus. Now type in 1-6-0-3-1-9-8-0. Hit equals. Okay, so Terry, you could have taken any bill. Simon, you've been holding it throughout. Open up that bill. Every bill is printed with a unique serial number. Please read me that number.
Seven.
Seven.
Four.
Four. Next.
Two.
Two.
No.
Four.
Four.
One.
One.
Zero.
Zero.
Four.
Yes.
One.
I told you the two things I tell everybody. America's Got Talent turned my life completely upside down. Oh, and I want to savor every moment.
That's for real.
To America's Got Talent.
Thank you.
And what is your name?
My name is Brett.
Hi, Brett. And where are you from, Brett?
I'm from North Carolina.
And what do you do in North Carolina?
Twiddle my thumbs.
You're a thumb twiddler?
Yeah, a little bit. I like to entertain people, you know. I come from a musical family. My grandfather was certainly an entertainer, and my dad, he grew up wanting to be a rock star. And that's, you know, kind of why I'm here, to kind of live that dream for him.
So he didn't become a rock star?
He's a cop.
Okay. And why did you choose to come on America's Got Talent?
This is, you know, I've gone as far as I can go, and this is where it's brought me. All roads have led to this X right here. Sappy? Too sappy?
No, I like it.
Oh, okay, all right.
Well, show us what you do, and we can't wait to see it.
My name is Brett Loudermilk, and I'm a sword swallower.
Oh.
As if you didn't already know that. I need a woman from the audience to help me out. Let's see who we've got. Sophia, can I please use you?
Yeah, join me over here, Sophia.
Up the stairs. Thank you so much. Join me right over here.
I'm not gonna swallow anything.
No. You.
No.
No. Wait. Stand right there. You and I are gonna swallow a sword. I'll swallow this when you're gonna help, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna place the sword into my throat and let go. I'm gonna hold it there with the muscles of my esophagus. I'll snap my fingers, open everything up. It's gonna drop down the rest of the way by itself. It's gonna bump. I'll bend myself into halves. I'll turn towards you and wink. When I wink, you grab the sword and you pull it out.
No, I'm not going to pull it! What if I kill you?
You were the wrong choice. Okay. You ready?
No.
Just nice and slow.
Okay,
here we go. You have to watch.
Focus,
face me. All right, here we go.
No, I beg you, I can't.
What part of when I wink did you not understand?
It's winking.
We're gonna try this again,
no,
okay?
But what if I put it in?
Okay. My career has led to this. Here we go.
Look at his face. Look at his face.
I don't want to.
Pull it.
He can't do it.
Pull out the sword.
I can't.
Just pull it out.
It's stuck there.
No, it's stuck. It's not stuck. I promise you. This is so easy. I promise. Okay. Yeah. All right, last time. Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Can I be honest with you? Sophia was atrocious.
Well, you don't know what it felt like. When you touch it, it feels like it's stuck in there and I was going to hurt him.
Is he finished? Well, that's not his act.
I've got more. No, she...
Go on, please.
Okay, thank you.
Would you like Sophia back on stage?
Absolutely not.
May I continue?
So, I've decided to bring along this one. Now, this is what we call in the business a wiggly one. Now, because of its shape, when I swallow it, you're gonna see the sword through my throat.
No, no.
Pull one out.
Seriously?
Yeah.
No, do you
really want to pull one out?
You really want to pull one out? Let's do it.
Okay.
Come on.
Come on! Come on!
Wait. Howie, would you do it too?
Are you serious?
Yeah, come on.
Serious. Would you do it too?
Well, wait. Let me ask something.
You need something. No. All three.
Wait.
I already did it.
Come on. Right, find your safety spot.
Somebody shout out a number. 3, perfect. All right, good. It just so happens that I have not one, not two, but 3 swords.
3 swords.
That I'm gonna swallow at the same time because you asked for it.
Really?
And each one of you is gonna pull out a sword. I'm jazzing right now. This was not planned.
I know. I had no idea.
Have you got this before?
No, it doesn't matter. Listen.
You're gonna put all 3 in your mouth?
I'm gonna swallow the 3 swords. You're gonna pull out, I'm sorry. You're gonna pull out the last one, okay? So it's gonna be
you. Sure about that?
Right as rain.
Will you really wink at us?
I'll wink. So I'm gonna go down the line with swords in. I've never done this before.
3 at once.
Here we go.
The whole sword.
All 3. Here we go.
Then we'll put
you start with the top.
Yeah, we'll I got it. Okay.
Here we go. 3 swords.
Oh, no.
Here we go. Here we go.
Let's concentrate.
Thank you.
do you mean, okay? Do you know actually what you're supposed to... This does not look good to me.
My name is Florian Saint-Vey. I come from France.
And what are your plans if you win this?
My dream is to have my own show and to do a world tour with it. Before to do it, I need to show my magic to the world. And that's
so
it.
So you're a magician?
I'm a magician, yeah.
Okay, perfect. So show us your magic.
My name is Dom Chambers. I am 26 and I'm from Australia.
And what do you do in Australia?
I do magic.
Have you had a really tough gig? I know as a comedian I have.
I was once hired to perform magic at a funeral. You can imagine how tense that was. It was like, I'm so sorry for your loss, but is that your card? Is that the one? It was...
What did you say when you got the booking?
I said, how much?
So why America's Got Talent?
Well, this is the biggest stage in the world, and I don't want to be doing those shows anymore. This is where I want to be.
All right, well, good luck. Go ahead.
Okay. Folks, if you would like to see the appearing glass of beer trick, say yes.
Yes!
All right. One, empty. Paper bag. One dramatic magic gesture. One beer coaster. No, that's not it. This is the appearing glass of Beatrix! Now, they say a good magician would never repeat the same trick twice. Well, lucky for you, I'm not a very good magician. All right, here's one for the non-beer drinkers. Bottle of wine in the bag. Fwah. A tiny bottle, please. Bang, wine!
Whoa!
Come on, here we go. They say, don't worry, in case of an emergency, always bring a spare
coaster.
But where there's a coaster, there's a beer. Not there. All right, now we're warming up. Nothing in the sleeves except for the coaster. But other than that, absolutely nothing to hide. No hidden glasses, no hidden beers, except for that one. Here we go, America! Bag, coaster, beer, yes! And another, come on! All right, here we go. No jackets, no sleeves, no shoe. That's my shoe.
Sorry, we do not talk, but we will be glad to give you answers only after you can ask the question according to the answer.
Okay, well, let's start with your name, please.
We are the Demented Brothers.
And where are you from?
We are going to do magic.
Okay, what would it mean to you to win? What would you do with $1 million?
Yes.
Okay, what's your ultimate dream? This is really important, this question.
Thank you for your questions. Now it's showtime. You will love it, Simon.
Okay.
not.
It didn't work.
I'm so confused.
Watching this show, as I love America's Got Talent, I realised that you, Simon, and Howie are BFFs.
We love each other.
We do.
I know, from watching the show,
no,
right?
We actually do.
But they say a friendship will only last if they have a subconscious connection. So I want to test out your subconscious connection up on stage right now, Simon and Howie, in front of America. So come on, come up.
You up for it?
Come on. Lovely to meet you, Simon.
Welcome.
Lovely to meet you. You good?
We've never done this before.
No.
It's like never.
It's like being
amazing.
On a date.
It is. I'm really nervous.
Scream if you guys need help. We'll run and get you.
Yeah. Thank you.
You ready?
Yeah.
Perfect. So now, as you can see, I have two decks of cards here and a blindfold. So, Simon, you're the boss. So choose the red deck or the blue deck. The blue deck. Perfect. So as you can see, we'll get rid of the box. These are all different, yes?
Yeah.
Perfect. Face down like this for you, Simon.
Yeah.
And now how will you get the red deck?
Okay.
We don't need the box. Okay. As you can see, these are all different, yes?
Yes.
Incredible. Now I'm gonna place these face down. Okay. Now the reason for this is because it's gonna be your subconscious choice of choosing a card. So hold out your finger over the deck for me like this, both of you. And go left to right for me, left to right, over the deck. Do the same, left to right. And I want you to look each other in the eyes for me. Whenever you want, place your finger down on one card in your own time. Perfect. And Howie, what one do you want?
This one.
Perfect.
Okay.
Now this is the thing. If you had a connection, then these two cards must match. So take the cards, don't look at them just yet. Take them, pick them up. Don't look at them, hold them against your chest. On the count of three, you're gonna show the audience. One, two, three, show the audience. Have a look, have a look, have a look. A perfect match. There we go, right there, a miracle. Incredible.
Amazing.
But wait, see, this is where it gets interesting, because I want to take this a step further. So Howie,
yes.
Here I have a blindfold. Please, could you put this on for me?
Okay.
Perfect. Now, Howie, I'm just going to touch the back of your hand. You don't mind, do you?
Not the back.
Can you feel this pressure here?
I do feel that.
Good, Howie, take a deep breath in and out. We're gonna see whether you two are connected. Do you feel this pressure, Howie?
Yes.
Good, take a deep breath in. Now, Howie, you're doing great. When you feel this pressure come off, raise your hand slowly to a height of a wine bottle. Only when you feel this pressure come off.
Okay.
Interesting, Howie, when you feel this pressure come back down, when you feel this pressure come back down, place your hand back down to the table.
Okay.
Amazing. But wait, that was me controlling your mind. We're gonna see whether you're in sync. Simon, it's in your hands. Point like this. Simon, whenever you want, you're gonna control Howie's hand. Just raise your hand slowly in your own time.
So I'm controlling
Howie. Whenever you want. This is incredible, perfect. Thank you so much, Howie, you're doing great. Now I've got you two in sync, I wanna try the last experiment to see whether you are actually subconsciously connected. Simon, as you can see, I have loads of things here, right?
Yeah.
Now I want you to choose one of them, anyone you want, just choose one. Perfect, we're gonna get rid of that now.
Yeah.
Hold it in your right hand like this for me. Now Howie, turn your right hand palm towards the sky for me. Now just in your imagination, you imagine holding something inside your hand. You focus on the texture, the color, the shape of this thing. Do you imagine something inside your hand now?
Yes.
What do you imagine holding?
Cookie.
A cookie. Take off your blindfold and have a look what I've just handed Simon. A cookie. There we go. You guys have a subconscious connection. Mm-hmm. Look at that.
After our incredible journey, we are thrilled to be back on America's Got Talent, The Champions.
We've been so lucky to travel around the world. We also receive tons of mail. People want to know everything about us, but also about the churches.
Yes. Oops. And probably the number one question they have about the churches is about your love lives.
Oh. Right.
Oh. Oh, I love this act already. Already.
Please stand up and join us on stage.
Churches, churches!
They're about to get in their business!
Simon, always a pleasure.
Likewise, nice to see you.
Right next to Heidi. Thank you.
Howie, yes. Right next to me.
Okay.
Excellent. So, judges, I need you to imagine a dream date, okay? Simon, Heidi, come with me.
Where's a dream date?
Perfect. On the table, Simon, here I have 100 different postcards from cities all over the world, okay? Look through them, they're all different. I like you to pick one city for your dream date, okay? Don't show it to anyone. Just put it inside this envelope, hold it like this, and bring it back to the judges' table, okay?
Okay.
And Heidi,
yes.
You will select one candle.
Okay.
Anyone you like, put it inside this bag, and also you can bring it back to the table.
Okay.
In the meanwhile, Amelie will blindfold herself, and I will look away. Howie.
Yes.
You are next.
Okay.
Think about a gift bringing to your dream date, okay?
Okay.
Any gift you like, make it random, be creative. Not the usual, I don't know, flowers, candy, okay?
Okay.
Whatever it is,
yeah.
Write it down here and place the board face down on the table, okay?
Okay.
That's for you. Please do that on your seat. Oh, thank you so much, Howie.
All
thank
right.
you.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Melby, you will be caretaker of this box.
Okay.
Hold on to it. Please don't open it yet. Just bring it to the judges' table. Thank you so much, Melby.
Thank you.
Do me a favor. Imagine your dream date involving your choices and send your thoughts towards Amelie now.
I will start with Heidi, I want you to imagine the fragrance you chose. I think it's something very romantic. It reminds me of a nice summer evening. The scent you chose, I believe it is campfire.
Can we see your candle? Campfire. Was Amelie right?
She was.
Now, Simon, let me continue with you. We are not in the United States. You went further away. I believe the city you chose, it must be Shanghai, China.
Is that correct? Can we see your postcard?
I'm going to be honest with you. I did pick somewhere different, and at the last moment, I changed it to Shanghai.
Finally, Howie.
Okay.
I believe it is something very unusual to bring to your dream date.
Okay.
But Howie, I believe to your dream date, you will bring simple pants.
Pants? Is that correct?
Pants.
Yes, it is.
No!
What?
A big round of applause for Amelie.
You don't want to show up without pants.
That is correct. Oh, one last thing. Mel B, you have the box.
Yes.
Do us a favor, open the box and let us all know what's inside.
A remote control.
Take it out, because we save the best for last. Mel B, press play. Hi, everybody. The show hasn't loaded in yet. Nobody is here.
But this morning, Amelie said there is something she has to do. Let's look what she's been up to. Amelie knew that Heidi would pick Campfire, that Simon would go to Shanghai, and that Howie would bring pants!
That's crazy!
I love Simon's face!
This is what scares me, because they got second, and I feel like they're a little mad. And they're like, you know what? We ain't getting second again.
My God, that's just crazy. Oh, you're brilliant. You're absolutely brilliant.
Thank you so much, Melvie.
Really
thank
are.
You.
Heidi.
First of all, I have to tell you guys, you definitely were one of my favorites 2 years ago, and you just totally wowed us again with this amazing act. I mean, pants, how random is that?
That's
I mean,
so
it
random.
Is unbelievable. You guys are so great.
Thank you
well
so much.
Done.
Thank you, Heidi.
Simon.
I mean, I was like, ah! I mean, this has just blown my mind. I mean, seriously.
Boy, you set the standard, because that is going to be tough to follow. The whole purpose of this show was for people like you who didn't win, let's give you another shot and let's see if you've improved. This was way beyond anything we'd seen before. I'm going to be really honest with you. Good luck. Why not the golden buzzer?
That's my golden buzzer today.
Why? Why not?
I was just being random.
I changed my
really
car.
Did you really?
Yeah, I had Honolulu, and then I put it down, and then I put Shanghai. Issy.
Hello.
You look even smaller. Maybe the stage is higher, but
probably.
You, it looks like you shrunk, but you haven't. Now, introduce yourself, please.
I'm Issy Simpson. I was on Britain's Got Talent in 2017, and I was the runner-up.
Aww.
And how old were you then, Issy?
I was 8 then,
eight.
But now I'm 10.
Wow.
Issy is a champion in my eyes. I can't wait to see what you're going to do tonight.
Yes.
Good luck.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Tonight I'm going to show you something with my two favourite things, magic and reading, using my three favourite books. My first favourite book is Colin Davis' Mathemagical. Mel B, please can you look through the book and check if each page is different?
Yes, it is.
My second favourite book is Enid Blyton, The Magical Faraway Tree. Heidi,
yes.
Please can you look through the book and check if each page is different?
Will do.
My third favourite book is How to Make a Million. Please can you look through the book and check if each page is different?
It's also my favourite book.
Probably the first book you ever read, Simon. Please, can you pick up my box and put it on the floor for me, please?
On the floor?
Yes, just behind you.
Behind me?
Yeah. Mel B, do you want to go and help him?
It's very heavy.
Girl power.
I can't lift it.
Exactly. No, it was...
What is going on? How's that possible?
Stop!
Oh, okay.
Please, can you both sit back down for me, please?
All right. She's a little bossy.
Oh, show off.
How's that even possible?
Howie, I'm going to show you a card trick, but it's a card trick like no other. As you can see, all the cards are different.
Yes.
I'm going to turn them face down, and I'd like you to touch the back of any card.
There.
Are you sure?
I am.
I'd like you to look at your card, remember it, and don't show anyone else.
Don't show anybody else?
Anyone.
Okay, got it.
Now, Howie, there are three books. Please choose one book.
I want to make a million.
How to Make a Million has around 674 pages. Please, can you choose a number between 1 and 674?
126.
Simon, please, can you turn the book to page 126 for me, please? Now choose one word and in a loud voice tell everybody what it is.
Excellent.
Excellent. See this blackboard? Before the show, I wrote a word on it. Watch. Card.
Yeah.
For the first time, Howie, what was the card you chose?
It is the Three of Diamonds.
Watch.
Oh! Amazing! I'm gonna sing soon, thank you! Good night!
So what I'm doing this time is sufficiently different.
Oh yeah, this guy.
I like that.
This chance could change my life.
From the kitchens of North London. How sharp? I will show you how sharp. Oh! It's not a perfect situation, to be honest. Apparently I'm fine. Apparently I'm fine. All right, I've put this off long enough. One more time.
What I love about you is you are a showman and you show a different side of yourself. You're taking a gamble. That gamble paid off. Well, wish you the best of luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Magic Mike Jacobson.
Magic Mike Jacobson. So you're going to be doing magic.
That's right.
Well, what a coincidence to have that name and to be doing
pretty
what
convenient.
You do.
Yeah. Yeah. The movie was loosely based on my life.
Okay. How long have you been doing magic?
I like did magic everywhere I could, from like my home to barbershops and everywhere in between, and eventually kind of just like rose and rose and rose, and would love to keep doing it, you know? So that's perfect.
Okay, and how old are you?
36.
36, and where are you from?
LA.
And how do you make a living? Do you make a living doing magic?
No, not yet. I work in advertising by day, but this performance will determine whether I can quit.
Oh.
So we'll see what happens.
No pressure.
Yeah, no big deal. But actually a huge deal for me.
Well, let's see what you do. Are you nervous?
Exactly, let's see.
Yeah, I'm a little nervous. I'm also just excited to be here.
Well, wish you the best of luck, buddy.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna share something with you all tonight that every magician has, but no magician will show you for some reason. It's this. It's an invisible deck of cards. It's a bit hard to see in this light. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna burn the invisible deck from 52 all the way down to 1. At the end, Simon, you're gonna be a hero, as you always are in my heart. And you're gonna save one of the remaining cards from burning, but it depends on what Heidi and Sophia decide. Heidi, take that match. I don't want you to strike it and stare into the flame. Let's just say there's two groups, number cards and face cards. We need to decide whether you want to start to burn all the numbers or all the faces. Blow it out when you're ready.
Am I telling you?
Yes, please.
All the faces.
The faces are now on the fire. You can pass the box over to Sophia. Sophia, take your match, okay? Left in the fire, we've got jacks, queens, kings. Okay, the only way to divide those up would be, yeah, men and women. I want you to burn that match. And tell us, do you want to burn all the men? Do you want to burn all the women to a crisp?
Oh, the men.
That was a very quick decision. You go ahead, you blow it out. And you can pass that to Simon. You're going to save one of the remaining cards from burning. All we have left are the four queens. Queen of hearts, queen of spades, queen of clubs, queen of diamonds. We're going to light that match. And whenever you're ready, blow it out. I want you to draw with that match the suit of the queen that you want to save. Hearts, spades, clubs, or diamonds. Is that a diamond? Here's the thing, are you sure? Simon, if you shake the matchbox, do you hear something in there? Open that up for us. Because in all of your hands the entire time, there's been nothing but one card sitting inside there, protected by a paperclip. I want to make sure, singed, like it's been in a bit of a fire. You guys could have saved whatever you wanted to. But you and you and you decided together to save the Queen of Diamonds.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
No.
I appreciate that very much. But this is America's Got Talent. I'm here to take this to the next level. And so, Howie, I don't know if you noticed, but there's an invisible deck of cards right next to your cup. Howie, if you would, I want you to just shuffle the deck for me, please. But you might want to take it out of the box first. Oh. Thank you.
Stupid me.
Great. And now feel free to show off all your shuffling skills. Just make sure it's really mixed. Oh my God.
Oh wow.
That was very impressive.
He's so good.
Howie's a pro.
Now, Howie, what I want you to do is just fan out the deck to yourself and pick out any card you want. Don't show me, but remember it. Make sure everyone can see it. Great. Howie, if there's an invisible Sharpie right next to your cup, sign the back of the card for me, just with your first name.
Okay.
Great, I don't want to see it. And now, take the card, slide it right back in, put that all back in the box, and then throw it right back up to me whenever you're ready. Perfect. Now, you, just minor miracles, it's fine. Howie, you shuffled the deck.
Yes.
You picked a card, you all saw it for the very first time. What's the card that you picked?
10 of clubs.
I want to clarify something. You and I have never met, correct?
Never.
Nobody came up to you before the show, said
no.
anything?
No.
For the very first time, I'm going to open this up. You said the 10 of clubs, correct?
I did.
Because every single card in here is face up, except for one.
Uh-oh.
One card with a signature on it. Howie, can you confirm, is that your signature?
It is.
Will you flip that over for me?
Are you kidding me?
Is that your card? Thank you very much.
That's crazy.
Thank you. Thank you.
And he kept all his clothes on.
Heidi, what do you think?
I mean, the audience was so quiet. I haven't heard this audience this quiet all day. I mean, we were all like, like hanging by every word that was coming out of your mouth. And it was incredible.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Really cool.
I'm like mesmerized. It was like fantastic. And it was funny at the beginning also with the invisible part.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Good job.
Thank you.
I'm going to make a prediction. No more advertising jobs for you. Because this is what I think you were born to do. Genuinely.
Thank you.
Yes!
Thank you so much.
I gotta say, and you know, people at home are always skeptical because they think, I swear to you, nobody here was in on this. This is my signature. That was incredible. I loved it, you know? I think it was really good, and I think you're really good.
I'm gonna start the voting with a yes.
It's a yes for me too.
Sophia?
Yes!
And Simon, 4 yeses!
Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you, Cheryl. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Magic Mike! Oh my God! Listen, how are you feeling? Tell me.
I feel amazing. I feel like I've had so much stress all day, and now I feel like so pumped.
That is crazy.
That's my signature, too.
Is it your signature?
It is my signature.
That's crazy, Tom.
It is crazy. I know, I want to keep this.
Hello, guys. Hi. Tell us your names, please.
My name is Steffi Kay.
And my name's Mysterion. We are mentalists. We like to get into people's minds and essentially mess your heads up.
Good.
And what better a stage than to do it here?
Well, we are here to hopefully see your life change.
You got it.
Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please draw an image of something simple enough that if you were to think of it, you could transfer it through the air and into Steffi's mind. The audience has done the same, and they're being collected right now. If you could pass down the judge's drawings and you're gonna randomly take one of them out, great. One, two, three, her eyes are closed. Steffi, you have an image?
Okay, so I'm sensing something. I think the earth. Did you draw a tree? I see a tree there.
That is in fact the image of a tree. Which judge drew this? But you know what? I saw this. So we're gonna try it a little different. Up there on stage is a wind machine. And to randomize these, we're gonna drop them into the wind machine, but we're gonna ask for Terry to help us out. Come on out, a big round of applause!
What would you like? Oh, here.
All right, we've brought along a pair of safety goggles.
Okay.
You're gonna go ahead and put those on. I'm gonna dump these in here. All right. Hit it!
Oh!
When you got one, let me know. You got one? Amazing. Come on out. Don't let anyone see what it is. In fact, I don't even want to know what it is. But you and I collectively are going to put that image into her mind.
Okay.
And if, Terry, you would just pass me that, making sure it's facing you. You have an image?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What is that an image of, Terry? If you could just say what that is.
It's a heart.
It's a 100% match.
Oh, no! Whoa! That was incredible!
I think a couple people drew this image, but the name of the person who drew this image, Chelsea.
Who is this person who drew the heart? If you would just put your hand up and say hello, Chelsea with a heart.
Chelsea.
Stand up.
There she is, there she is.
That's yours.
There it is, that's real. I'll never know. I grabbed this at random.
Okay, Gabrielle.
I was wowed. When you hear the audience reaction, I think everybody was pretty wow.
There's something like really magical and mysterious about you, and I love the fact that it had to do with love at the very end.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
The presentation for me is a little weird. I don't know what it is, but it's a presentation that's more off than what you do.
I'm afraid I'm with Howie on this. I'll tell you why. This is a great introduction to you, but you want to be at the top, you have to have more imagination. Okay, right, we're going to have to vote. Julianne, what do you think?
Well, I'm going to say yes.
Gabrielle.
Yes, number two.
Howie.
For me, it's a no.
Look, guys, I like you. I think what you did is good, but it's got to be great.
Well, this is only the tip of the iceberg.
Well, couldn't we have had the iceberg?
I have an idea, if you would let me.
You do whatever you want. You know what's gonna happen.
Simon.
Yes?
There you go.
Thank you. I would like you to think of any celebrity in the history of entertainment.
I've got it.
And I want you to print the name down on that piece of paper. You can use your pen. He doesn't trust the marker. I'll take a peek and look. Keep looking at her.
You picked something from your childhood.
Yes.
Something that you grew up watching, even reading. Lassie.
So Simon.
I knew if I said something critical, you would do something better. You got three S's. You're through, well done.
Thank you.